everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be my everyday skincare morning routine. I have decided to break them up into morning and evening. I originally filmed one with both of them and I just did not like how it came out. It was too messy and a little confusing, so I scrapped that video and decided to break it out into two. But man, with daylight savings, my whole schedule is totally messed up. Even though we just move an hour forward, I feel like I'm just really exhausted. I feel like I can't get anything done. I start work at 8 and then by the time it's 4 o'clock, I'm just like, what did I get accomplished? Speaking of work, I just started my new job. It has been amazing. I am incredibly blessed to have this position. So far, so good. I mean, you probably think it's only week one, but it's been really good. I've jumped right into things and I have so many ideas I cannot wait to bring to the team, and everyone's just been so supportive. The team, my friends, family, colleagues from my previous employment have been really encouraging, and just some people I worked with as well. It's just been like overwhelming with like the love and support I have in my professional career on YouTube and the blog. It's just, I'm incredibly lucky, and thank you guys so much. It really does mean a lot to me. It keeps me going, especially like when times are tough. 2018 has been really great so far, but we're also house hunting and my number one contender. It didn't work out, so I was a little bummed, but Griffin and I did a lot of research and we have two new leads and we have a appointments to check out these places, and we're just really incredibly excited. Life's exciting, you know, there's all like these moving pieces going on, and like I've mentioned, I've been really trying to get videos up on Tuesdays, Thursdays. I originally wanted Saturdays, but with just everything going on, it's just been really, really crazy, and I hope you guys understand. My channel is still growing, and that's just kind of been my ambition of trying to get 3 videos up, just to, you know, kind of get out there. I am happy how 2 videos have been working out a little bit. I know some weeks I've only been 1 and I apologize about that. I know I'm rambling. I just have a lot on my mind that I just want to update you guys with, so thank you. Let me just get my thoughts together. But before we jump into the morning routine, if you're new here, hi, welcome. I'm NVR Shout Amanda. That's been like my handle name ever since like, I want to say freshman year of high school, and it's just been something that stuck with me. It's easy, it's fun. If I ever make a cosmetic line or skincare line, soaps, all these ideas I have in my head written out on paper, that would probably be my brand name, so it's just something I wanted to keep with. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel before you leave and ring the notification bell to be notified for future content. And also give this video a thumbs up if you really enjoyed my everyday routine. I have all these ideas I want to do, and I know I do mainly unboxings and demos, so I'm trying to keep it a little fresh just to keep things exciting. I don't want it to go stale really quick. I hope changing it up a little bit caters to you. Let me know what you think. So yeah, let's jump in. Okay, so my morning routine isn't as intense as my evening routine. It's kind of just a basic routine in my opinion. I've started using less products than I usually did, and I think it's been helping out a lot with my skin, especially when I had the oily problems. Right now my skin is cooperating, and it's really a good sign because it started warming up. That free trial of spring just went away. It snowed on Monday, and today was incredibly windy, like how it was a couple weeks ago. So I don't know, the weather needs to make up its mind. Kudos to my face for finally getting its life together. So the first product I like to start out with in my morning routine is the Garnier Active Micellar Cleansing Water. I think it's just a really good way of priming the face. You know, you prime your face for makeup. I like to prime my face before cleansing and making sure I'm getting into the pores, removing all of the gunk out. You know, when you're asleep, I know for me, I get really hot. So there's sweat, there's oil, there's dust floating around. I know I don't see the bugs, but I'm sure there are little microorganisms crawling on your face. So I just think it's just a really good step in priming. And just to double check, that's where product number 2 in my routine comes in. You have heard me talk about these wipes. I rave about them in all my empties videos. They are these simple cleansing wipes. I just like to make sure everything is like a really clean slate, because it's just really hard to really get in to your pores to really clean them out. I just don't feel like just jumping into with a cleanser would really do you any good, because it would only be like half-assing it instead of doing a really good job. That's just my opinion. It's something that works for me. If you have a skincare routine, definitely check out doing like a priming step just to see how it might help help. I know I've noticed a difference, especially after I use those micellar water, because I put it on a cotton round, and after I'm done wiping my face, I see brown and black stuff, and I'm like, I don't know if that's leftover makeup from the night before or what, but there's definitely something on there. I like to believe they are dead cells, so that's what I'm gonna go with. After I prime my face, I go in with a cleanser. I've been kind of bouncing back between two. I've been using the Glam Glow Exfoliator for a while now, but I've also been interchanging with the Ole Henriksen Foam Cleanser. Megan actually gave me that sample size to try out. I'm really liking that brand a lot. I wrote a blog post, I can link that below, of what products I really enjoyed using from her skincare routine. All of her products were Ole Henriksen. That was my first time using the brand. I've always seen and heard about it, but I really like that foam cleanser a lot. I think it's really good for the morning. My face feels incredibly soft, both from using Glam Glow and the Ole Henriksen in the morning. So like my face just feels really soft, smooth, and I'm just ready to get refreshed from there. Especially in the morning using the foam cleanser, it has a very citrusy smell. So it's just like a nice aromatherapy of just, you know, getting in the swing of the morning. After that, I go in another product I've talked about for a while are these Rapid Clear Neutrogena wipes. I'm almost out. I think I have like two left. I'm thinking about trying the First Aid Beauty ones also. And Peter Thomas Roth also has some wipes as well. They will be on sale for Ulta's 21 Days of Beauty. I'm just really excited because I really like that brand as well. I just want to see how other pads work. I know they target different trouble areas. For this one focuses on acne, I think First Aid Beauty and the Peter Thomas Roth ones target fine lines, dullness, redness, other signs of aging that I'm starting to experience. Yes, I am starting to experience some signs of aging. So I definitely just want to see how it works. So I'm trying to think, how can I best rotate the two different types of pads? Definitely these for if you're a female and you have that time of the month, that's when I really depend on these pads just to prevent any type of breakouts. But I would like to kind of rotate, maybe using those for like 1 week and then switching off to a different brand like the following week, making them on a bi-weekly schedule. It's just something that I've been playing around in my mind right now. So I'm just really excited to try to give those a try. I really have been using those Neutrogena ones forever now. Forever. I probably have been using them just as long or not longer than I've been using my handle name of NVR Shout Amanda. After wiping my face with one of those pads, I like to go in with a toner. I really like the Thayer's Witch Hazel. Thank you guys for recommending this to me. A lot of you guys, when I was experiencing the oily fiasco, you all recommended the Thayer's Witch Hazel. I have been loving it. I was using a L'Oreal toner for a while. It just wasn't doing a lot for me. And the thing that really pissed me off about that toner, it said alcohol free. But then like the second inactive ingredient had some kind of alcohol in it. And I was just like, lies. Like I called it out. I was super upset. And anyway, so using the Thayer's toner has just been a lifesaver. You know, not every routine needs a toner. A lot of toners tend to dry out your face due to alcohol, where toners are supposed to replenish moisture after cleansing. So it's really hit or miss. I really like the Clinique cleansing toners as well. I haven't used that outside of the three-step process, so I'm not sure how that would work, but it's something in my mind as well that I want to experiment with. But right now, I've been using since January, and I've just been like really happy with its performance. And it's really calmed down my redness of my face. I'm naturally like flushed and red in the face, so I have definitely seen a difference of it calming down, and I've just been super pleased how that toner has really worked well in my routine. I have two products left. I feel like I apply so much stuff on my face at night, and I'm looking at my morning routine, I'm like, where is most of my products? I like to go in with a moisturizer after toning. Excuse the toothpaste tool to just to make sure I get all of the product out as opposed to cutting it. But I'm using the First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Cream. I have really been liking First Aid Beauty. I'm thinking of doing a series on my channel or the blog about products that family or my mom, friends recommend to me, because I have always heard of First Aid Beauty, but my mom was the one who purchased me my first product, and I've just really been loving the brand. It is a cream moisturizer. I think it does a really good job of really hydrating the face. Creams are thicker than gels, but it like goes in so nice. Like, I don't really have to like rub in really hard for my skin and my pores to absorb it. It doesn't just lay on the surface. It gets right in. Like, my face just soaks it up and loves it. It has not been causing me to become oily throughout the day, which has been really, really awesome. I was a little nervous because of it being a cream, it being heavier. I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna produce more oil, but I'm having a really good balance right now. It doesn't really have a scent. It kind of just smells like cream, if that makes sense. I've just been really loving that. And I have some other First Aid Beauty products I really want to try. Like, I have their serum. I want to compare it to the Ole Henriksen. You can read that in my blog that I will link below as well. But I'm still in search of that, but for the evening, not the morning. And so since none of the products I have mentioned have SPF, I like to go in with some sunscreen. I was really thinking that at first I was like, there's probably some polysorbate or propylene glycol. Something is causing me to go oily, and this actually has propylene glycol, so I thought that was really playing a role into why my face was becoming so greasy and oily, but now it seems to be calmed down. I was still using the sunscreen even though I was paying the price of my face literally looking drenched. I know it's Target's generic, so I'm not sure if it's that or if it's a sport, but I really like to have sunscreen over my face because I have done damage to my skin living in Florida most of my life, so I'm trying to at least make a difference and make a change in my skincare routine to try to prevent further skin damage or skin cancer. Even if I don't leave the apartment on the weekends, I will still do my normal routine and I will still apply sunscreen just in case, you know, but I only do it the once. I should probably carry sunscreen in my purse just to replenish. At least I put it on in the mornings, at least when I get up for work and I leave my apartment, go to my car. So I know that sounds silly, but think about it in like the long run. But yeah, that's my everyday morning skincare routine. It's pretty basic. There used to be a few more steps in it. Like, I used to have an eye cream and I used to double tone, but I kind of just cut that back just because it's the morning. I don't think you need as much product on your face because your face will be exposed to so many different things throughout the day. So I think that's why I've changed. And I think that's why my nighttime routine is more intense. I will definitely do a video so you can see how different the morning and the evening routines are. But yeah, most of these products are very, very affordable. Obviously, the facial cleanser and then the moisturizer are definitely the most expensive. These three are not full sizes. This came in like a fun set. Like I said, Megan gave this to me and this came in like a bundle that I purchased. So the full sizes, don't really know how much they cost off the top of my head. I know they've reformulated the Glam Glow. I think the Ole Henriksen, I think it's about $28. And then this moisturizer, I think it retails for $36. I know it's a little bit more pricey than the average product, but I really do believe in investing in skincare. You know, you only get one face, so might as well take care of it. I know growing up I was a lot cheaper with it, but now I have honestly been spending more money on skincare than makeup recently. I kind of just turn to BoxyCharm or the Weekly Wows or these Ulta sales to be the chance of to purchase makeup, but otherwise I'm kind of like, ooh, what does Peter Thomas Roth have, or what's new with First Aid Beauty, what's new with Ole Henriksen. So I've just kind of been definitely focusing on it, and I've seen a huge improvement in my skin. You know, I rarely get broken out. Oh, my stress, acne, and my texture have gone down tenfold. So like, I've just been so incredibly happy, which has led to some laziness. I have neglected my face a couple days. There was one night and one morning where I did not cleanse my face, and I really, really hated myself the next morning, because you can definitely feel a difference in your face and how gross it is. I highly recommend you guys to take care of your face. It's just really, really important in my opinion. I'm a huge advocate for good skincare, good skin. It's very important to me. I hope it's important to you too. So thank you guys for watching today's video. I really hope you enjoyed my everyday skincare routine. Like I said, stay tuned for an everyday night routine. I also plan on doing everyday makeup routine as well. So yeah, thank you guys for your love and support as always, and stay tuned.